I'm going to tell you how you can use Autopilot and some of the features that are true about Autopilot, as well as some of the things that are false. Coming up. So before we get started, make sure you hit the like button as well as subscribe to the channel. So I wanted to do something a little bit different and cover a topic that someone had interest in. I had a friend reach out to me and ask me to explain how Autopilot worked on the Tesla. And today I'm going to cover that and explain exactly how you can use it for your daily driving or on long trips. So in all the Teslas, you have the two knob or two handle system. On the left, you have the turn signal functions, and then on the right-hand side, you've got the knob that allows you to go in reverse, neutral, or drive. And of course, to put the vehicle in park, if you need to, you'll click this button here, which is the park function, and the vehicle will go into park. I'll show you exactly how Autopilot works, how to engage it, how to disengage it, as well as controlling your speed and how the vehicle will accelerate and decelerate. So the car is driving itself and it is in autopilot currently. The foot pedals are being controlled by the car as well as the steering wheel. Now if you adjust this side, it adjusts the volume. If you adjust this knob, it will increase your speed up or down. Now to engage the autopilot, you click down twice on the knob here. If you want to disengage like I'm about to here, you'll click up once and the car, you are now in control of the vehicle. If you want to re-engage autopilot, you will click twice and the car is now driving by itself. Now first I want to cover what autopilot is not. So there are some false things about autopilot and I want to kind of clear up what those are. The first thing is that autopilot does not allow you to sleep in the vehicle. I know you may see some images of people that have their autopilot on and allows them to take a nap or whatever it is in their vehicle, but I want to let you know that that's not true, especially with the new vehicles that have the updated software. The car actually prompts you every 30 seconds to a minute or so to give it some sort of input. So the input that it requires, either you can adjust the volume on your music, whether it's up or down. You can also adjust the speed, whether it's up or down, or you can squeeze the actual steering wheel to give it that input. It requires some sort of input on the steering wheel, whether you do one of those three things. So either adjusting the volume up or down on your music, or adjusting your speed up and down, or just squeezing the steering wheel will allow you to continue driving in autopilot. Another thing that I wanted to kind of clear up about autopilot is that the car won't actually do everything for you. So what autopilot kind of seems like is that the car at this current stage will do everything for you. Now in the future, it will have software updates that allow you to pretty much sit in the passenger seat and the car will drive you from one destination to the next. But right now, the car has the technology to do that, but the current laws in place do not allow the car to actually drive you from one place to another without any input from you. So I want to kind of cover some of the things that are true about autopilot. One of the things is that, again, autopilot will take you from your destination from start to finish, essentially. If you're using what they call full self-driving, it will allow you to go from your on-ramp of where you're leaving from on the interstate to your off-ramp. It'll make all of your lane changes for you. It'll accelerate as well as decelerate and handle all your braking for you. So all of your steering wheel movements will be controlled by the car. Everything will be basically taken over by the car. So it'll switch into other lanes and overtake vehicles that are going slower than you are and go back into the lane. So autopilot allows you to really enjoy it. And it's one of the features that Tesla has introduced that has been great. So if you're interested in something like autopilot, I encourage you to go and test drive a Tesla and experience autopilot and see what all the hype is about. Because once you're in autopilot, it'll change your life. It'll change your perspective on driving and how you may or may not want to drive on a daily basis. Now, again, I just wanted to do a quick video on how autopilot works and how some of the features are true about autopilot, as well as some of the features that are not true about autopilot. Again, if you found any value in this video, make sure you hit the like button as well as subscribe to the channel. Make sure to comment below and let me know what you think about autopilot. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you on the next video.